So let's direct our attention to the board on the, in the third portion here. And here are just some, these are fun things, but they really result in just so much really great, authentic relationships that can be million-dollar partnerships 6 years from now, 10 years from now, 15 years from now, 20 years from now. You don't know how long you're gonna be on planet Earth. So making that first impression is so key. So something that I've recently did at the previous conference that I was at, I came in with a do not sell mentality. No matter what, I'm not gonna sell anybody anything. I'm just gonna talk to people. I'm gonna share with people what I do, how I do it, where I do it, etc. And then each day I'm gonna invite people to dinner. Now I've got a little etiquette rule that I have for myself, and those of you can follow this as well if you create the budget for it, which is if you're gonna invite someone to dinner, you cover the bill, okay? So if you're gonna invite somebody to dinner, I believe it's only right to at least make the offer to cover the bill. And if they say, no, I got it, I can handle it, okay, great, I won't push too hard. But typically, I like to approach with that. It sets a very good first impression in terms of how you value that person's time, that person's energy, that person's attention when you do something like that. You invite them to dinner, okay? You connected with somebody at the 10 a.m. session, at the 12 p.m. session, during lunch. You said they were, you know, you thought they were really great, and then in the hallway coming back to the room or whatever, you're like, hey, let's go to dinner. Are you doing anything this evening? I'd like to take you out. Awesome, yes, great, let's go. So invite people to dinner. That's, you know, roughly 2 hours, sometimes maybe 3 hours of networking. And I'll give you a story. And this was just a pure fun. This is pure fun, because that's another goal that everybody should have when they come to FinCon 2021. Have fun. I'm already seeing the emails. I'm seeing the energy from the host, people that are hosting FinCon and working it. I'm seeing this energy of like, this can potentially be, you know, a bit of fun. So give you a quick story. I was at the Vault here in Hollywood area, South Florida. And we're staying at the Diplomat Hotel. Part of this was only 1,000 people. I think FinCon's gonna be more than that. So this is a 1,000 person event with tables in rows like this, right? So while we're at the event, the host, Patrick Bet David, every couple hours or so, he does a case study. And for 15 minutes, you gotta turn your chair around, look at the person behind you, and you're in groups of four, and you discuss a case that he presents around business, right? Turn my chair around. I turn around. Behind me are a commercial real estate investor, gentleman, and then a lady has over 230,000 followers on Instagram. She gives me her name, her Instagram. I look at her, I'm like, holy crap, this person's got almost a quarter million subs on followers on Instagram. That's awesome. And so it's a couple. So I think they were married, I'm not sure. These people were from Jersey. And I could hear the New York, I heard the accents already, the up north accent, and that's when mine started to come out. I'm originally from Queens, New York. My accent is damn near gone, but I do know how to turn it on when the moment's right. And in that moment, it was right, because then later that evening, we got some mojitos at the bar after the event was over at the hotel. And then they invited me to dinner. I had my girlfriend with me, staying in the hotel. I said, babe, we're going out. And we went to this Cuban restaurant, and there was another couple. So it was six of us total. I had the craziest laughs. I mean, I have not laughed like that around strangers in God knows how long. I can't tell you how relieving it was to just be in person with people. We're drinking mojitos. We're having nice Cuban food. Bunch of, you know, all Spanish people around us, you know, we got Cubans, Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, Guatemala, like it was just an awesome, and we're just cracking up. Mind you, I'm 25 years old, my girlfriend's 23, and the couples that we were with, they were in their, I think, late 30s, mid 40s. So they're about almost double our age, but I mean, just the connections, the laughter, you get a couple of mojitos in you, you start opening up, you know what I mean? So it was a ton of fun, and with that, that right there was like 50, 100, it was a priceless moment, couple hours to, you know, simply started with inviting people to dinner and it resulted in a hilarious night. They were hugging me the next day. They were just awesome.